Not a very good way to start a landing, and not a good way to start a film either. Made many years ago, I'd put the wrong year on the caption. It was January the 9th, 2007, not 2008. And if you're wondering about the noise in the background, it's an elephant seal, not one of us with indigestion. Gold Harbour, on the southeast of South Georgia, is a breeding ground for king and Gen 2 penguins, and also for elephant seals. There's a glacier coming down into the bay, which, as it melts, causes a glacial stream to run along behind the shoreline. At this time of the year, the stream is littered with feathers as the birds molt, replacing their worn-out feathers with new ones in order to stay waterproof.
Back there, we've got the Gen 2, you can see some pictures. Yeah. Thank you.
this pair of king penguins are going through their courtship ritual. They mature sexually at the age of 3, but are more likely to start breeding when they're about 6 years old. They mate with one penguin in each season, and unlike some species, tend to find another mate the following year.
Thank you.
Every now and again, there's a fur seal that doesn't like the look of us and can be a little aggressive. Mariano, one of the expedition leaders, had to stand his ground with this one to ensure that it backed off. This is a giant petrel. They have a wingspan of up to about 7 feet. They're very aggressive predators and scavengers, and the whalers in their time used to call them gluttons. By 9:30 we were back on board for coffee and a warm-up, and as the ship moved on we began to see more icebergs around us. We were heading to Cooper Bay, where we went on a Zodiac cruise. Sasha was our driver this time, as he set off to a point at the end of the bay so that we could see a colony of macaroni penguins. With seals jumping and playing in the water all around us, Sasha manoeuvred us expertly between the rocks so that we could get really close to the penguins. And these macaronis have little tufts of feathers sticking up out of each side of their heads. In the 18th century, macaroni was a term used for someone who dressed flamboyantly, and English sailors obviously thought that the term fitted these penguins with their gold crests. Sasha took us in really close, so that we were only about 3 feet away from the macaronis, and they watched us with almost as much fascination as we watched them. Today, January the 9th, was my mother's birthday. I thought it'd be interesting to try and phone her from the ship. There was only one phone on the bridge. It took a little while for the radio officer to set the call up, but he got through, and I managed to wish Mum a happy birthday. Well, that took her by surprise. The only problem was that all the crew and passengers on the bridge could hear everything. This was the ship's main phone with no private booth. Well, as you can see, as we travelled south, around South Georgia, the views were spectacular, and most of us were out on deck as much as we could to enjoy them.
is the light. In every stone sleeps a crystal. Remember the shaman when he used to say, man is the dream of the dolphin.
That's why we are here.
Having left South Georgia, we were on our way to the South Orkney Islands. We really knew then that we were heading to Antarctica. There were icebergs around us everywhere. They looked huge to us, but we kept being told that these were babies compared with what was to come. As we passed one large and extremely blue-coloured iceberg, Bob, the Canadian doctor travelling with us, said the colour looked like that of the dick of the last boy he circumcised.